Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about the Singleton design pattern. It's a pattern where we have one instance, a singleton of our data model. I've seen it used some places. There are both upsides and downsides by it. Personally, I think that this design pattern should be avoided unless there's a really, really good idea to have this pattern. And the reason is that it makes a code less testable. So if we start creating a package, I'll just show what the usual scenario is. So here we have a data model. So this is my data model right here. Then I'll create a class named data model. So this is my data model, and here then I will create a singleton. That means that I will access this data model statically. So I'll have a private data model like this, and start setting it to null. And then we will usually have a private constructor. So let me create a constructor like that, and then I'll change the scope to private, so no one else can actually initialize this data model right here than itself. And then we will have a public static. This also needs to be static. So we have one data model that's right there, that one that right there. Then we have a public static, and then we have something like get instance or just instance or something like that. And this will then return a data model like we have here. So, and then we say if data model, if that's null, so we lazy initialize it. That's also, of course, we could also have eagerly initialized it instead, but now we are lazy initializing it. Then we do some stuff right here, and we say data model equals new data model like this. So then we get a new data model, and then we return the data model in the end. So that means that the whole program and all the classes that needs a data model, they will go through the data model there, and then they will actually use the get instance method to get an instance of the data model. Let me just remove this from the constructor. We'll just have a default constructor, which is private. It's not default then, but yes, we just have a constructor right there that doesn't take any arguments, which is private. So the problem with this is that then all the other classes, when they need the data model, they will just get the data model from this get instance right here, and then they will traverse through the whole model. Then the idea is maybe we have a space station, private space station, like this. So we have a space station. And we'll just create this class. We don't have it yet, so I'll just create this. I'll just have I'll just make them public right now, so it's a bit faster to write. Public string, name of the space station. Maybe we have a list of spaceships on the space station. I'll also create that list. So here we have a spaceship, and here we have a public string. We have a name of the spaceship, and maybe we have a number of crew members, so crew is right there. So we have a spaceship name and the crew. We could make it a bit nicer. So we'll say this private, we'll set this to private. I'll create a constructor. And then we have the spaceship right here. I'll do the same with the space station. Let's set this to private. And private list of spaceships. Spaceships, and I will create a constructor. That will just take a name, and then we will set the spaceships to new spaceships equals new list, new array list, like this. And then maybe we can add some. We will create some methods so we can add spaceships like this. Public void add ship. And then we have a spaceship like this, spaceship. So what I'm creating here right now, that is a data model that we can access from other classes. And then usually what happens is that the classes, instead of actually being fed in a constructor with maybe a list of spaceship or one spaceship or space station, then they will be fed with nothing. And then the classes then will actually use the singleton instead to get the spaceship that they actually need. So add spaceship, then we say spaceships dot add, and then we have a spaceship right there like this, and then we say public Spaceship lists, or maybe spaceship, and then we'll get it by name. So then we'll say get by name, and we'll have a string name right there. And then we can return, then we'll say spaceships dot and then we can get just one of them. I could actually convert it into a stream first. Stream dot filter. Then we'll say the spaceship dot get name. Spaceships, let me just check right here. Spaceship s dot spaceship private. Okay, I need some getters on the spaceship. Create getters. They're there. Then I will say get name, and I'll say equals ignore case, and then the name that we were actually looking for. And then we will collect the spaceship right here. Collector. Collector. To list. Or to set. Or to list, that's fine. And then we will just get the first spaceship that we have right here. So I know that a lot of things can go wrong when we create this right here. I'm just trying to get a data model up very fast, and then we'll say return that. Return. So now we're fetching one spaceship that actually matches the name like that. A spaceship here. What we have here? Get. What does it say? Can I return the value from method with void result type? Filter, so we have this filter right there. Oh, we have a semicolon up there. That was not it. We have this public spaceship get by name. String name, and then we would have the spaceships we put into a stream. We collect it as a list right there. Let me just remove the get. Let's just see what we have here. Right here, we have a list. Return collect dot get, and then the first one. That should be okay, right? That should be okay. What is wrong here? That's something here totally wrong. Let me just see here. Ah, okay. The brackets did not match. So, okay, now it's, let me just see here, add spaceship. Yeah, okay, so now the code matches again. So what we have here now is that we have a data model, we have a space station right here, and when we're initializing the data model, of course, we could go down in the database and fetch stuff, and we can also save stuff to this singleton, because this is a singleton, because there can only exist one instance of this, because we have made the constructor private. Here we can initialize some stuff. We can say space station equals new space station, and the space station should have a name, big one, big spaceship, space station. So this is a big station, big space station. And of course, we can also add some spaceships, big space station, add ship, and let us add some spaceships, new spaceship. And we can get a name, square 100. We can have a round spaceship, round, we can have a pyramid, pyramid. And let us have a, actually I want to be here, pentagon. So it's a pentagon, and then we have a different number of crew members right here. And this is our data model. We have now we are initializing our data model with four spaceships whenever we create this singleton right here, and that will be lazy loaded because we are doing this only the first time that we try to get the data model. Then we will get into this code right here. It's null. Yes, it's null. Then create a new instance and then initialize all the data right here. So this is a singleton that we create right now. Let us say that we actually wanted to create some code that could help this. Maybe it should actually print out one of the spaceships, so it could be a spaceship printer. So let us just create that. Then we would probably create a new class like this, or a spaceship print out helper. And this prints out all the spaceships. That's the purpose of this one. It's a utility class that we're creating. So, and then we can have public void, print all. And then the way we would actually get this now is that we will get our data model, and this is how we would access our data in all of our classes that actually need the data. So then I'll say get instance, and then I'll say get the space station. We have not exposed that yet, so I need to expose that data model. I need to create some getters. I'll insert getter, and then I need to get the we create a getter for the space station right there. Getter. And then we have a space station, which is right there. We can say get space station dot get by name, or maybe get all of them. Let us just create one that's actually get all space ships. So let's do that get getter for the whole. Then we go to the space station, that's right there. Create a getter. Get the list of spaceships, expose that. So, of course, I could have made it immutable, so I should have returned a new immutable array list if I wanted to do that. Right now, it's just an example, so I can actually also change the list from outside. That's the, I know that that's very ugly, but get all, get spaceships. Should we make it immutable? Immutable. Let's keep it this for now. So here we have the spaceships, and then we take each of these for each, and then we have each spaceship like this, and then we say system out print, or let us use the system out f, the formatter string. So then I can actually use the string formatter pattern in here. So then we can write the name of spaceship colon, and then percentage s and crew members. And if you saw the string format video, then you would remember that percentage d is an integer, percentage s is the string, this is a string representation. And then I can write and then we also want a new line in the end, that percentage n. And then I will use s dot get crew member. First I'll have the name s dot get name. And then I'll have the crew members right there. And then it actually just prints all of them. So let me just create a new run method. So I'll create. It could also have been a test, but right now I'm just creating a. This is my singleton demo right here. And I can just write main because it's IntelliJ. And then I get the main like this. And then I can say new spaceship printout helper. And then I can just say print all. And look here, I have not given this any arguments at all. So let's say that I wanted to test maybe four other spaceships or maybe 1,000 other spaceships. Then I had to first go manipulate the data model. And then afterwards, then I could actually, then I could call the print all. So that's why I don't like this pattern at all. I like having classes that we pass on the arguments to. I would like to give the spaceships that should be printed as an argument to the class instead. Yeah, but it is a pattern, and it is actually used. I remember when I did some iOS apps that that one of the first thing, if you read if you read the manual there, was do not use a singleton as your data model on iOS. And the reason why they say that in Apple's documentation, or at least did say that in Apple's documentation, that was that of course it takes up too much memory, and it's, yeah, especially in old days when there was not that much memory on the mobile platform, then you had to really consider memory all the time, and a singleton data model was not a good idea, because then you would run out of memory. Yes, so let's say that I want to test something different. Then first I would have to go and manipulate the data model. So I'll go to data model, get instance, and then I'll get the space station. And then I would add some other sheets. Right now, I don't even have a remove spaceship method, but it doesn't matter. We will just add some new spaceships right here. New spaceship. And then a new name that could be, what should it be? That'd be a flat spaceship, which has maybe 1 to 3 crew members. And I can add some more. Almost flat. One. And then let us say that this just be 10 crew members right here, and let us run the code again. So yeah, so as you can see, it makes it very difficult to test these two new spaceships. Now I have it mixed up with all the initial spaceships and what else is on the data model. Yeah. So that's it, ups and downs. So that was the singleton design pattern. I'm going to demonstrate more design patterns right here, and I'm going to reuse this project right here named design patterns. I'm uploading it to GitHub. So yes, feel free to leave a comment, and thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again soon. Have a nice evening. Bye bye.